Jeez, as if I needed more problems right now. 10 years of disorder. Well, fine, that's how little I fear it. However, unfortunately, the excellent leader Jagger has now left us. We need somebody that's pretty great like he was, and I know just the man. It's gonna be Fenati. Is our age of good leadership gone? Because it feels like it is. Guess it's down to Laser Kiwi here. And they're rolling on in with people. See if I can't get there before the bulk of the reinforcements arrive. That's a big bulk of reinforcements, but these guys will die swiftly, I believe. 9th of September, I want to be there faster. Getting there on the 8th of September. Okay. I think I lost out time-wise there. Hey-ho! Let's keep those conversions going. 5, 6, 7. If you cancel before the day arrive, you don't spend the mill. And you arrive pretty much at the same time. Oh god, they're hurrying. This is not a good fight for me. Yeesh. Ottoman human wave tactics, die you slugs! Get out of my land! Jeez, oh. There's just no end to them. No end to them. Sure wish I had that diplomatic reputation and war exhaustion policy, because reducing war exhaustion reduces absolutism as well. It's their land, Jake. We'll see about that. Alright, that put a lot of them on the run. Let's see if we can't clean up a few of these miscreants. Squish, squish, squish. Like the bugs they are. On the plus side, though, it's been a really good day for converting all of these guys. Ottomans have a vast amount of troops. What's their manpower like? Probably untapped. Let's get rid of this. See war allies, war enemies and war allies. The Ottomans, oh, their manpower is going down, but they have a buttload of mercenaries. At least the lack of manpower will make them more keen on peace. Montenegro is making gains, plus 6. It's actually working for me for once. Okay, come on, come on. Let's hoover them up. We're going into the steppes here. They are running away. Or they're trying to run away. We'll try and hoover some of them down. You can't stop me. You can only hope to contain me. I'm coming for you, Otto scum. Every last one of you. God, there are so many of them. At least they love going for Crimbo. Alright, try and take out the leaderless ones in Caban. How are we doing on war score? We only have 25 from battles. We're going to get a whole lot more, and it's ticking up from battles, which is nice as well. Those kinds of squishes really help out. Look at that, 3.5 war score just from that. And these guys going to Azov, they don't know what hit them. As long as those guys stay on their way to that other province, they're locked in. And then you're going down. I should probably squish you together a bit, but it's okay. I need you to reinforce as well. Bringing them together is better for fighting, but keeping them spread out is better for reinforcing. Whew. Jake, Wallachia deserve their cores back. Wallachia deserve a lot of things for what they're doing here, but they did reset the core timer. Actually, those cores are never going to go away, so good for them. No, this is all about hurting the Ottomans as much as possible, which should really mean taking away... Is this part of Yugoslavia or Romania? I don't know. I probably will have to stop and consult the map before we finish this war up. Yeah, the Ottomans losing forts is pretty important because it makes it a lot easier to fight them in the future. Unfortunately, that means stuff like taking Constantinople. I should probably be pretty picky about taking out these forts. Dalmatia for me. Ah, crumbs, it's occupied by Austria. You are not allowed that, Austria. Maybe I should have taken this. Somebody piped up earlier about taking it, and I was like, "Proc, no." And now I can slightly regret that. Okay, fort. Where are his other forts? He's got one down there. That would probably involve me taking a bunch of land like that. Well, hey, that's pretty good. Odd that you fear the Turkmen so much, even though you're wiping the floor with them, because they're endless. I'm not endless. Besides, if I didn't get all my army together like this, and if I'd taken a few bad defeats here, he would be all over me. But no, we clamped up together, we teched up, and now we're kicking in his arse. And yeah, I did lose that 10% neighborhood bonus. It does take a nice effect like that. Consider taking land in Anatolia across from Greece so your men can move freely. No, I'm not taking Anatolian land. It's not Soviet. But Greece is, of course. Was it worth losing Timmy? Maybe. Depends how badly Timmy gets slapped in that war. Allies will come and go, though. Timmy was one of the better allies I had. It is sad to lose them, though. Okay, that auto stack is still quite terrifying. And it's well led. It doesn't have any particular weakness. I'd still like to mop the floor with them, but I'd rather they reinforce a battle that he's already losing horribly. What can be done about this? I could split up and actually get some troops back. That would be nice. I don't want to run the risk of losing it all once we've gotten this far. So yeah, let us take a step back. There we go. That way we both get the turn of the month stuff in these more accommodating provinces. With Timurid's gone, Ming just got 50 allies to 50 reasons to ally you. Yeah, but I need 50 more right there. That said, though, it's probably worth bringing up those relations once more. Not allied to your rival anymore, and I'm fighting your other rival. Oh, good. Commonwealth are getting involved. That's nice, getting those reinforcements back on. Expected. I think I'll just have to let them be for a while. Alright, Commonwealth are going to have that one down pat, but I want to find those leaderless or badly led Ottoman stacks. Sadly, Ottomans have a plethora of good leaders. I have to fight for the good leaders I get. Take you down. Second. Really? I doubt my tag is earlier than yours. Lower Yick. Ah, nice. Wait, what? Oh, right, they have it occupied. That's a strange one to have occupied, but hey ho. Oh, well, I'll be damned. My tag is earlier than theirs, or something funny is happening. Whatever the case, I move in for the kill, and I kill lots. This is great for the war score. We actually have the full plus 40 from battles, and the more Turks I step on, the better I feel. The self-esteem grinding strats are real. Hosing these suckers down. It's not about alphabet, it's about tag order, which is an internal thing in the game. They're not quite willing to give me 65% things, but. But. The longer we hose them down, the better. Wow, even the Commonwealthy has given them what's for. Commonwealthy has great morale. Military drill, advisor, army tradition, focus on field defenses? What is that? Is that an event or something else? Whatever, let's go and curb stomp more Turks. It's the right thing to do. Oh, and they want to come and fight. Great. They get locked into Caban. No river crossing, sadly, but there is a death crossing. Oh, they were going elsewhere. Huh. Well, they still get to die. Shame that they have such great leadership. Shame for me, that is. Good for them, I suppose. Tag order is not an alphabetical thing. For example, Sweden is the first tag. And tag order is used in some things. Orders of battle, for example. Or tie-breaking in certain decisions, like who gets to be the Holy Roman Empire. It's very low on the list of considerations, but it is a consideration. Now, sadly, these battles are no longer contributing to war score, because we already have the full 40. But it gives us a bit of a buffer in case they... in case they start winning a few battles. Poor Timmy. And God, they're just... they can't be stopped, the Ottomans here. I know, the best thing that I could honestly do against the Ottomans is take their fat stacks of cash and drown them in debt. In addition to, of course, taking their cores away from them. Check out Wallachia and Anatolia. Yeah, it's pretty ballsy. I admire that. It's very tempting to actually go on in and assist. I'd need to take my own fort back, but that shouldn't be too hard. It's a pretty grim fort, after all. Ah, jeez, the Danes are probably going to split up across all of their provinces there. But the Commonwealth is on the case for me, that's nice. Nicest thing the Commonwealth has done for me in some time. I'm going to split in half, take this back so I can assign a decent general. I'll still 10 to 1 these guys. Because I have a 4 siege general that I would rather have help out with this, and hopefully the Ottomans don't come and stomp me on this mountain. They don't, Lorraine takes over HRE. I admire your tenacity, but I don't think you're going to win this. But I do admire. Yeah, get out of there. But it didn't chew into our war score because we have way over 40. Oh. Why are they sending in those guys? Well, there's a slight chance I can take this fort in time, but it's very slight. Battle's going to happen on the 30th. Really? It's taking you that long to get here? Let's try and take the mountainous fort, because it would be a big laugh if it was fought on our terms, despite the costs that entailed. And let's bring in that extra extra pain. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. They're going to get a good mountainous attack on us. That said, what we have might still be enough. We are stronger after all, but there are a lot of them, sire. Oh, but he's coming in piecemeal. But there are a lot of them. Let's not mistake the fact that there are a lot of these suckers. They can work wonders for advancing this if they keep coming in and dying horribly, though. Because they can give extra siege progress. Oh, sheesh. Not against that many. That is not a fight for me. Unless they rolled extremely badly. It is only 2 in their favor. Wait, why is Wallachia still there? How is Wallachia still there? Sounds risky. I'd run. Yeah, they do have a lot of reinforcements coming in. But what if, by some miracle, we slaughtered them all? You know, with a 9 shock roll. Yeah, they have too many coming in. It's a shame, though. A real shame to drop such a good siege. There's no way I can beat so many of these bugs, though. Yeah, I gotta get out of there before we lose everybody. Shame though, that was a good going fort. It's alright, manpower pool is holding. How about their manpower pool? Insatiable. And they have even more units now. Wait, am I looking at the right guy here? Yeah, I am. 304,000. Yeah, that's a lot of Ottomans. I don't have that. Timmy War is over. They still hate my guts. There's not a lot I can do about that as long as they want my lands. How about that debt of yours there, Ottomans? He makes good money. He makes damn good money. He's only got two loans. I could give him five more. Feels like all my campaigns end up this way. Big war against Ottomans. Alright, one of you get over to these hills. We'll try and... Well, no, Circassia instead. Let's get some manpower back. Oh, well, here comes Commonwealth to give me some attrition. Thanks, aw. Thanks, my greatest ally. Oh, we can get our manpower back over there. They're coming up to give me some great pain, but... The Muslims are all gone, so... It's not all bad. Some might even say it's pretty good. Let's go for the fast, cheap, and impactful Christians, then. He's chasing me down. Subject's getting revolts because he can't convert his land. Ottomans, oddly enough, are Meechum in this. Ignoring the money thing, they still wouldn't give me up the land, but they almost would. Give it another month and they certainly would. I'm still getting ticking war score here. I need more maneuver. Maneuver is good for reinforcement, of course. Ah, that's rather nice. The Ottomans are going to be tanked by those Commonwealthies. A 6-6-2-4 general. That's a fight and a half. And he has reinforcements coming in. Help them. They don't need help. The Ottomans are going to die there. Actually, here's a thing that I could really do to help. I could hold this so that they don't get reinforcements. Look at this fight. The Ottomans are all kinds of dead. Well, that's some good rolls, Ottomans. I'll give you that. It's not good enough. I would still rather like that siege, though. Let's send in the cannons and the four siege to take it back. And try better to defend it this time. The Bashkirans want to rise up. That's what I have a fort there for. Yeah, the Ottoman morale is getting tanked. Uh-oh. He decided to slither across here. I like that. Haven't we reached the point where morale means less? Less, of course, but less doesn't mean worthless. No, that's kind of what it means. Doesn't mean it's insignificant. And it is still quite significant here. Let's get these forts back. Let's try not to lose Constantinople. Hopefully the Commonwealth is on that, because I can't afford to be on that right now. Took care of my rebels and besieged my land for me. That was very, very nice. This isn't so nice. They're coming in to attack me here, and they're locked in. Laser Kiwi, we need your expertise. That's not so nice. I'm going to put defensiveness on here so that they don't take that fort in a heartbeat. Although they have 7,000 cannons, they probably will. Ah, jeez. They really like holding this fort. There we go. Just let me take my stupid fort back, man. There we go. I'm not going to fight you in those marshes, but I want you to know what you can and can't do. Hopefully you go over to Imereti because I'm sticking you there. Good, because I'm going to come right back into Imereti and kill you on my terms in my mountains under Laser Kiwi's guidance. Alright, unfortunately Constantinople's going down unless the Commonwealthy get there fast enough. Well, they should get there fast enough. I mean, it's only 20, 35, 49% chance. There, that's what it feels like being stuck in a mountainous fort. Sick and tired of these auto scums. Maybe I should take this and release Bulgaria and do a big reconquest where I take back all these lands. I think Holy War is still better, though. Or I release Greece. And then... Oh, goddamn, Greece don't have cores here? What is going on? How do Greece get their cores, and when do they get their cores? Because I quite like them. Go, go, Commonwealth. You know you can take them. The Greek rebels never rose up. Greek ain't even in the Eastern Bloc. Listen, I need to declaw the Ottomans here. Whoever I say was in the Eastern Bloc will suddenly find themselves in the Eastern Bloc. I would take these, but I know that that massive stack of auto freaks just got pushed back into Ottoman lands, so they're willing to come back out now. Don't you dare start showing favor for the Greeks now at all times. I don't think Bulgaria is going to be enjoying this province then. I think I'd rather have it for myself. I mean, they'll get all this. Actually, that's quite funny. It's all Wallachian cores right now. Yeah, at this point, I think I want Bulgaria out and existing. Tell you, this isn't a bad peace deal to get on those Ottomans. They won't have good access to these lands anyway. I'll split them up quite a bit. That is nice. Right, we just need to push them down a little bit more and this will be ours. Of course, we need the Commonwealthy to actually protect Constantinople. Good, they're doing so. On the 27th. Krivens. I'm not sure if that'll do it or not. Don't know what'll happen, the flip or the or them arriving in time. Okay, Laser Kiwi on one fort. Von Dougal's on the other. It's risky, but I want to grab some forts while I'm here. On this day, you liberate Constantinople from the Turkish menace. And their morale's going down and down, probably because they're losing prestige from all these battles that they're losing. No, of course not. Truce with Timmy is up. That's scary, because Timmy could well attack me. With his slew of allies, of course. Come on, Ming, throw me a bone here. I don't remember Istanbul being in Soviet hands. Yeesh, the stuff I gotta deal with here. Ottomans need to be crippled. There's no ifs, ands, or buts in that. Uh-oh. This is what I was talking about when I said they'll come storming in here. Oh, but we do have Austrians helping us out, but it is mountainous. 26th. I can get out of there on the 18th, but they're still going to be there on the 15th. Well, it was a fun one. Let's back away. Should have listened to my own advice here. It's a single battle, so I'm not concerned. We have plenty of war score. That said, I don't want to lose my men to this. Alright, he is low. He does not want to be in this war. That said, neither do I. I've burned a lot in this. He he's still happy because he's enjoying a few fights, but once those fights are over, like now for example, we can get this sweet peace deal. But was it all worth it? Declawing the Ottomans? Yes. Losing Timmy? Painful, but we'll have to make do. Could even take some dosh for our work here. I would love to take a lot more dosh off of the Ottomans, but all in due time. I'm keeping this land for me. It's lovely Orthodox land. And it's part of my new Soviet bloc. In my head canon, they owned Greece. I'll see what to do with this land in the late game. I want some proud Wallachians. There must be some Romanians watching right now. If so, you've earned getting Gyu back. I think I sold this out to the Ottomans a long time ago, so it's only fair, right? We can all be proud Wallachians. That's the spirit. He keeps that fort, but it's easy for me to go and take these over. I should reinforce the fort in Constantinople as soon as I can. Alright, this is good. This is a great peace deal. Snake borders are coming back. That's fine. Didn't even take a look at the overextension I get. That's fine. Okay, lovely. We got cleanup to do, but that cleanup is going to be done at a later date. That was exhausting. But not nearly as exhausting as tomorrow will be. Most of the day is going to be spent on the weekly one-shot. It's Zelda Ocarina of Time again, but this time a randomizer. So everything you thought you knew about the game is going to be changed up. And there's going to be crowd control as well. That means if you're watching, you'll be able to do horrible things. Also nice things, so I hope I get nice things. You can give me bombs and heart containers and low gravity for me. Or you can give me iron boots when I'm drowning in water without the Zora tunic on. Or you can freeze me, hurt me, reduce hearts, kill me. It's pretty rough. But I'm interested in trying it out because it looked cool on one of the marathons. So we'll be having that tomorrow. So until said streams tomorrow for me, it is a cheers and very much a cheerio.